Hey, hey, this is Sharon Lee, and you are watching Fearless Empower Tube. This is where I create videos all about mindset, entrepreneurship, and intentional living. So if you're interested in those things, be sure to subscribe to the channel. But today we are talking about the top healthy habits for 2021. It really reminds me a lot of the life wheel. A lot of life coaches and business coaches use the life wheel to help their clients with clarity. So I really want to be able to touch on that a little bit. And the way that it works is it's basically a wheel where we're dividing that up into categories of focus. So we're focusing in on our relationships, our career, and we're talking about money. So in this video, I'm going to put the money at the very end of this video. So be sure to stick around for that. But let's start with the mind, because if we are moving forward in 2021, we really want to focus in on our mind as a big part, because hey, if you've been following me for any length of time, you know I love talking about how we can rewire the mind, right? So 2020 was not that great of a year, guys, right? So a lot of my friends and family were like really trying to kick 2020 to the curb. And welcome in 2021. So we realize maybe not a lot has changed in 2021 as we're recording this. It's January. But what we want to do is we want to start creating some habits, some routines in our life that more or less guarantee that 2021 is going to be a better year. So the first part of this I want to start off talking about, as I said before, is the mind. So when we're thinking about how we can create better habits for the coming months, this is something that we have to practice every day. So let's start off with a theme. So the theme would be a word. So what we want to do is we want to adopt a word of the year. You could go so far as adopting a word of the quarter, and that way you are focusing in on four words. And the reason why we want to do this is because words, number one, have vibration in them. I was talking with my 12-year-old about it, and she says, "Mom, I just realized I used to think stupid was a bad word." And I said to her, "Well, it can be when you're talking to other people." But she says to me, "Well, I would say it's about a thing." And I said, "Well, words have negative vibrations and positive vibrations. And the thing about that word is there is nothing good about it. You can't really ever say that that's going to be an abundant word. Like you want to use that regularly as a habit in your life." So we realize that words in and of themselves have vibrations to them. So it's important that we try to think of words as a theme that are going to help us. But the second part of this is the way that our subconscious mind works. Our subconscious mind focuses in on these words and tries to put a puzzle together. That's your reticular activating system working for you. So let's choose a word like organization. Let's say that that was going to be your word of the year. Maybe you felt really, really disorganized in 2020 and thinking that 2021 is going to be a much better year where you are feeling more organized. So when we're thinking about that word, for example, we would start looking at our desk, we would start looking at our room, our bathroom, and see how disorganized it was. Our mind would start focusing in on what is not organized. And also what your mind does then is it starts focusing in on how you can fix it. So you start thinking about how you can correct it, how you can organize things. So that's where your focus goes. And you've heard this so many times. Wherever your focus goes, your energy flows. So this is important for us to really understand so that we can adopt it. So another thing that would be really helpful for you to adopt as far as the mind, a new habit that you can create, and that is a declaration. So I'm going to go through explaining what a declaration is, how to use it, and then we'll choose a declaration for you. So sometimes declarations are akin to affirmations. So affirmations can work if your subconscious mind is on board with it. So here's an example of it not working. If you declared, "I am a millionaire," you know, you can walk around all the live long day saying, "I am a millionaire," and your subconscious mind is going to show you. Remember what I said before about the reticular activating system? It puts together the patterns. And so it's looking at your bank account of the past and current, and it's saying, "No, you're not." Liar, right? And so your subconscious mind is telling you that that's not true. And if your subconscious mind is not on board with it, then you're kind of out of luck. So what we want to do is we want to think of a declaration that is mostly true, that your subconscious mind can't disagree with. So I will share one with you. First, let's talk about how a declaration is done. And this is powerful because it uses your physical state, uses your body. And what we need to understand here is that your physical body is the language of your subconscious mind. You'll notice that when people are depressed, they hang their head low and that sort of thing, right? So we realize that when we're holding our body a certain way, our physical state, then this is helping our subconscious mind to click in. So what we want to do is we put our hand on our heart to declare something. And let me give you a declaration to practice with. "I am committed to constantly learning and growing. I declare this is true." So that's a declaration. So you put your hand on your heart, you're really incorporating your body, and you touch one of your meridian points, which is really connected to your body and your nervous system, and you're literally just putting it in your computer, and "I declare this is true." So that the thing is that your subconscious mind can't disagree with that. So "I am committed to constantly learning and growing." So this would be great for somebody who maybe doesn't like school, you know, who is struggling with finding the time to get off of social media. Maybe you're struggling like, "I want to get off social media. I see social media as a problem, and I could be spending more of my time learning about stocks, learning about fitness, learning about how to be a better wife." Those are good examples. We realize how we're spending our time. So it would be a good commitment, a good dedication that you could really implement right away. So think of something that your subconscious mind would be on board with, and that would be your declaration. Next up is health. I could mix the health and the fitness together, but I thought it would be better to kind of split them up. Because after all, health and fitness really are different. A lot of times people do lump them together, but they are very different. So here is a healthy habit that you can adopt today that will really help you moving forward in 2021. So this healthy habit, it has to do with you incorporating digestive enzymes. So digestive enzymes are really amazing for your body. So there's a lot of foods that we find that we have trouble digesting. And a lot of that are people who love milk and cheese, for example. And then even those healthy people who like vegetables, imagine that. Someone who likes Brussels sprouts or even broccoli, they cause gas for us. And we want to really be able to avoid that at all costs. And one of the things that you can do to help your body process it is to take digestive enzymes every day. So digestive enzymes are also helping us to absorb our vitamins and our nutrients better. So they help to process our carbohydrates, our fat, and our protein. So digestive enzymes really have a lot more going on to them than what we realize. And I think that when you incorporate a digestive enzyme, your gut health will be so much better. And we know that there is a connection between the gut and the brain. A lot of people are saying that your intestines are very similar to your brain in the way that it works. It's kind of like saying that intuition in your gut. So this is what science is telling us. That's not me. So I've done a lot of research on this and I really believe it too. So I know that I feel more clear, for example, when I've done intermittent fasting or any kind of a water fast or juice fast. So that means that I'm cleaning out my system and I'm incorporating digestive enzymes and things like that to really help me. So I did create a video on intermittent fasting and the benefits of that, and I will link that here. All right, so for fitness, this healthy habit for 2021 is not that difficult. I wanted to choose something I thought was really impactful, and it's so simple. And the reason why I chose this is because of what happened in 2020. It is the year that will be remembered for probably decades and decades, where we have been stuck in our homes and not really able to do a lot of the things that we were used to. And I really wanted to share a healthy habit with you that I thought would give you the best benefit. So moving forward in 2021, I believe that it's really, really critical for you to go outside and go for a walk. Something so incredibly simple and easy. We know that we can get our heart pumping and our lungs involved with having fresh air. We need that fresh air. And the sun is giving us the vitamin D, which is amazing for our immune system. And just being outside, away from the house, away from your phone. Don't take your phone with you. That's right. In fact, unplug. Take it a step further. Unplug from social media. Don't take headphones with you and listen to music. Really unplug from everything and go for a walk, even if it's just 10 minutes a day. This is something that would be so incredibly helpful for you, and it'll be healthy for your mind, your body, and your spirit. So along those lines, talking about health and fitness is well-being. So the well-being really has to do with how we're feeling about ourselves and about our life as a whole. So we realize because of what happened in 2020, we have been feeling a great deal of stress. So I want to share with you some healthy habits for 2021 that you can adopt today that are going to really help you with your stress. So what you can do is something called preemptive gratitude. So preemptive gratitude has to do with you being grateful for what you have right now that you actually want. So let's say that you wanted $1 million. So what we would do is we would say that you were grateful for the money that you have right now. So some of you that have been following me know that I was homeless for a time and I have had like no money at all, zero, and eating out of garbage cans. So I completely know what it's like to be penniless. I had other times when I came out of homelessness when I was basically just living paycheck to paycheck and I would have no money at all. So I understand what it's like to have your last $25 and you really have that lack mindset, like, oh, I've got to save this money. You know, I remember back in those days, you know, I would pull out the calculator at the grocery store. So I made sure to only spend that amount of money. If I had $10 to spend on groceries, I would plug it in and then I would either not put it in my basket or I would put it in my basket or some other different product. So I know what it's like to be completely broke. And what you can do is preemptive gratitude has to do with being grateful for that $25, is that if that is all that you have. So what we have to understand, if you're a believer in that the universe always has your back, if you're a believer in the law of attraction or God, then we realize that the world is abundant. We know that there is plenty of money. We know that there is plenty of resources to go around. But God does not give us more than we can handle. If we are not happy with what we've got, we won't get any more. And that's how it works. So what we want to do is we want to be grateful for what we have. So even relationships. Like if you were married before and divorced, and you're really like dreaming of this beautiful husband coming to you someday, you've got to find a way to be grateful for what did work in your marriage. Be grateful for what you did have that was good in your previous marriage or in any dating relationship that you've had. So you start looking and focusing in on what did work and how you can be grateful for that. And in this way, what we're doing is we're attracting more of what you're focusing in on. And this is how that law of attraction factor works with all of the gratitude. But this is preemptive gratitude. So this relieves stress. It attracts to you what you want, and it has your mind focusing in on abundance. So this is an amazing, healthy habit for you that you can adopt now. All right, we've got to talk about relationships. Here's the thing. We realize that sometimes we get kind of caught up in ourselves right up here in our minds. So what we want to do is we want to start thinking about other people in a way. So self-care is wonderful. We want to think about ourselves and taking care of ourselves. But remember that person that just didn't listen to you, where you were talking and having a conversation and they said, one word answers, like, yep. That does not feel good at all when you are on that end of the conversation. And we want to make sure that we're not doing that to other people. So your healthy habit that you can adopt today for 2021 in relationships is really being cued into listening. We really want to be able to learn to listen so that we can learn what that person is saying. We're not listening to react. So this is something a lot of people do. They're always listening for their turn to talk. They're always listening for when they can interject their point. In other words, they are not listening to that person and not really able to give that person what they need. So when we're thinking about our children or our close, intimate relationships, we want to be able to show them that we are listening to them and that we can really interact with them in a positive way. All right, so we got to get into spirituality. So we realize that there are six human needs that each and every one of us humans here on this planet have, and that is love and connection, and then we have certainty, and then the opposite of certainty is variety, and then we realize that we need to feel significant and important, and we also want to have contribution beyond ourselves so that we can help other people, and then we have spirituality. The thing about it is that most people don't even start working on their spirituality until they're much older. But what I want to suggest to you here in this video is that you incorporate something now so that you can start working on that aspect of yourself to really improve yourself this year. After 2020, I think we really need to start working on our spirituality so that we can be deeper people and start feeling better. So that's where spirituality has really helped a lot of people. Often they lean on that as a way to let go of what's not working and help them to focus in on love. So what I want to talk to you about here in spirituality is really how we've gotten disconnected in the digital world and how our chakras are all misaligned. And we want to really focus in more on how we can feel more calm and feel more love. So the healthy habit that I want to share with you has to do with breathwork meditation. So breathwork meditation is where you are deep breathing and focusing in on the breath and meditating. This is calming your mind and it's having you connect with your body. This is so incredibly powerful for eliminating stress and helping us to feel more calm. And it's something that you can do so easily, even just 5 or 10 minutes a day. And you don't even have to think about anything. And isn't it a great way to just really unwind and really just disconnect from all of the world and all of the stress? All right, so it's time to talk money. Money, 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 money. That's right. I saved this for last because it's so important. Money is what helps us to achieve our goals. It's what helps us pay our rent, our mortgage, buy our food, right? And take care of our children. Even these days, taking care of our health. So we need money. And we realize that with the stimulus checks that are being printed, the government is printing money pretty much in every country nowadays. And so what's happening is it's devaluing the money. It's devaluing the currency. So it's important for us to start thinking about ways in which we can really hold on to our money. So the healthy habit that I'm suggesting that you incorporate here is savings in high interest savings account. So this is where some of these savings accounts are a lot better than what you have right now. Most savings accounts, and you can check on yours, are 0.01, 0.02, right? So that's a fraction of a penny. But I know for a fact, because I use them, there are high interest savings accounts that are better than that, that you need to investigate. So I'm using Ally, and I can leave a link here in the comments below, and I'm not partnering with them in any way. It's just the bank that I use. They are, as the time that I am recording this, they are at 0.50. So that's an amazing savings rate. It's even better than most CDs. That's right. The certificate of deposits is, generally speaking, a safe way to save your money and make a little bit in 6 months, 12 months, right? But now you can do that in just a regular savings account, so it will be liquid for you when you want it. I have seen high interest savings accounts as high as 0.71, which is amazing when you think about how much you can save with your money. All right. So we want to help as many people as we can in 2021. It's all about raising our vibrations. It's all about sending out love to the world. So what we want to do is we want to like this video, because that's how YouTube works. It'll send out triggers to get more people to see this video so that they can be helped. We want to really be able to lift them up and help them so that they can have an amazing, abundant 2021. So let's spread the word and get as many people to live a better life in 2021 and beyond.
To infinity and beyond.
So if you like this video, be sure to subscribe and click the bell so that you can get notified of fresh videos when I upload them. This is Sharon Lee, and you are watching Fearless Empower Tube.